Hi there and welcome back to the Floss Marketing School. In this video, we are going to see how you can track with MapTomo Analytics interactions which are happening on an OpenStreet Maps map. And I'm going to use for that the platform name App Inventor 2 and hope I will be able to show it to you how you can make it on a website in another video. So let's imagine that you have an OpenStreetMap such as this one. How could you track and send the data to MapTomo? Well, if you are using App Inventor 2, in fact, you will use a web component because you will use, in fact, the API of MapTomo Analytics, which is the tracking HTTP API, where you just need to inform about the tracker of your instance. So in my case, I will look on my MapTomo instance. I will click over here on settings and then I will look for a tracking port. And when I look through the tracking port, I will get this famous URL on which I need to append some extra parameter in order to be able to send the data to MapTomo. And most of the time, that kind of parameter are what we call events, because that's interaction which are not generating any page view or anything like this. So we just need to inform about the category, the action, the name, and if I want, I can use the optional value. So to say, if I look at my code in App Inventor 2, I will get something like this. If someone click on a marker, which is nothing more than a point of interest, then what's gonna happen? Then the component that I have, which is the web component, is gonna be set to the given URL, so the one that you can see over here. So this is the tracker endpoint of my instance. Then the ID site equals 6 correspond to the website within my MapTomo instance in which I would like to send the data to. Rec1 means that I would like the data to be recorded. And then here are the different parameters that I would like to send. So the category, which will be hard-coded, which is OSM point of interest. Action, which is click. And then the name of my event will be the variable, which is here, which is global restaurant. And global restaurant is nothing more than a call that I'm making to an open data file listing the restaurants of a given city, the one of Angers. And I as well, what I want to do when I extract this given CSV file, I want to get the name of the restaurant, so as is latitude and longitude. So I all gathering this within a variable, and then I'm sending my request with a get. And as a result, so if I look at my app, so I can look at it like this. So this is my smartphone. Whoops, sorry for that. Just gonna switch it on the app. So here is my app. Okay, here is my app. So I can choose a restaurant over here. Okay, and let's go for this one, La Fabrique. I click on it, so I get it over here. So here at this point, no data are sent because I need to push the point of interest. So here, normally should get this information sent to my MapTomo. And let's choose another one. Let's choose this one, Restaurant Belle Rive. So okay, it's located over here. I'm just pushing it. Okay, so now if I look back on MapTomo, oops, and I'm gonna go back over here. So here is the log visits. Oops, the log visit is over here. And if I look for this given date, as you can see, I get my event sent, OSM POI, click, and the name La Fabrique, which have been sent with latitude and longitude, and same thing for the restaurant Belle Rive. And that's it. So as you can see, all the data are properly sent from this given mobile with all the user agent and things like this. And that's everything that I wanted to show you for today about how you can track interaction on a map dealing with OpenStreetMap and the HTTP tracking API of MapTomo Analytics. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.